Assalamu alaikum dear students. Today we will learn addition and subtraction by orally. Addition and subtraction by orally. See textbook page number 28. Till now we completed chapter addition and subtraction. Addition and subtraction. Let's see how to add and subtract orally. So see, first I take the pair of 28 and 53. So how to add orally? We solve this by the method that given in your textbook. See, the first one is how to add 28 plus 53. So first we add 3 to 28. So we get 31. Then we add 50. 50 means 5 tens. Then we add 50. That means 5 tens to 31. So 5 times 10 means 5 times 10 to 31. We add 5 times 10 to 31. So see, 41, 51, 61, 71 and 81. See, here we add 110 to 31. So we add first 110 to 31. So we get 41. Then we add 10 again to 41. So we get 51. Then we add 10 to 51, so we get 61. Then we add 10 to 61, so we get 71. Then we add 10 to 71, so we get 81. So we add 10 5 times to 31, so we get 81. Now see the another one. See, in 28 there's 2 tens and 8 unit, and in 53 5 tens and 3 unit. So first we add 2 tens into 5 tens, so we get 7 tens. How? 2 tens from 28, 5 tens from 53, and 2 plus 5 7, that means 7 tens. Now we add units. 8 from 28 and 3 from 53, so 8 plus 3 11 unit. 8 plus 3, 11 unit. And in 11 unit, there is 1 10 and 1 unit. So we add 1 10 to 7 tens. So it gets 80. 8 tens, 8 tens means 80. Then we add 1 unit. So we will get 81. See, 70 plus 10 plus 1. We will get 81. Now see the next one. See here. In the next one, see, 30 is nearest number to 28. 30 is nearest number to 28. So we add 3 tens to 53. 30 to 53, 30 means 3 tens. So we add 3 tens to 53. Means we add 3 times 10 to 53. So we get, first we add 10, so 63. Then add 10, so we get 73. Then add 10, so we get 83. So in this way we add 10 3 times, that means 30 to 53, so we get 83. See, 30 is 2 more than 28. 30 is 2 more than 28. Now subtract 2 from 83. So we get 81. Now see how to subtract. 28 from 53. So see, first you go backward from 53 to 28. So how many numbers do you need to go back? To reach 28? That's the answer. Now see the second one. See, if you subtract 3 from 53, so you get 50. Then subtract 2 times 10, so you get 30. See, if you subtract 2 times 10 from 50, so we get 30. Then you subtract 2. To get 28. to get 28. See, if you subtract 2 from 30, so we get 28. So this means that if you subtract 3, 10, 10 and 2, that means altogether 25. That means altogether 25. So we get 28. Means if we subtract 28 from 53, so we get 25. We get 25. Now then see the next way. See, you can find by counting forward from 28 to 53. You can find by counting forward from 28 to 53. You have to count from 28 to 53. So see, if you add 2 to 28, so you get 30. Then add 20 to 30. Add 20 to 30, so you get 50. Then add 3 to 50. Add 3 to 50, so you get 53. This means that if we add 2, 20 and 3, that is 25. 2, 28, so we get 53. That means if we subtract 28 from 53, so we get 25. These all are the method of mental and oral addition and subtraction. These all are the method of mental and oral addition and subtraction. See this exercise in your textbook page number 28. See the question. Add and subtract the following pairs of numbers orally. Add and subtract the following pair of numbers orally using your own method. If your friend method is different. So try to understand it. See, you have to solve this exercise by yourself, and if you discuss with your friend, so obviously your friend method is different. So try to understand it. Here I solve the first question from my method. See, the first one is 90 and 50. Here the first pair is given 90 and 50. So first we add this number. Okay. So see, in 90 and 50. In 90 there is 9 tens and in 50 there is 5 tens. So 9 plus 5, 40. 40 tens means 140. 40 tens means 140. Or you can add by counting forward or backward counting. If you add 5 times 10 to 9 tens, you get the answer. If you add 5 times 10 to 9 tens, so you get the answer. See, if you add 5 times 10, so 9 tens plus 10, 10 tens, then 11 tens, then 12 tens, then 13 tens, then 14 tens. So in this way you get 14 tens. Now we see how to subtract it. So see, 90 and 50. You can go backward from 90 to reach 50. How many numbers do you need to go back to reach 50? That would be the answer. In another way, if you count forward from 50 to 90. See, if you count forward from 50 to 90, that means count from 50 to 90, 60, 70, 80 and 90. That means we add 4 times 10 to 50 to get 90. That means we add how many times 10? 4 times 10 to 50 to get 90. That means if we subtract 50 from 90, so we get 40. See, you have to solve this exercise by orally. Here we completed this chapter. Chapter number 4, subtraction. Till now we completed 4 chapters. From the next lecture we start new chapter, which is multiplication. So we will meet in the next lecture with the new chapter.